please introduce yourself and what you do.
Hi, I'm Adam Gray, and I'm a social media author, speaker and advisor. So I work with medium-sized businesses to help them understand what social can and realistically can't do for their organisations, and then help them skill up and resource up and learn in order to be able to implement it.
So from your own social media perspective, and I suppose for some of the best practice you might teach people, how are you organising your, what's your objective, first of all, on using social media for yourself?
My objective is to cement myself as being a thought leader in the marketplace. So I have to take my own medicine. I have to be on it all the time.
Yeah.
So it's woven completely through my day. It's not like I block out time. I use it whenever I can. And it means that I'll be on it first thing in the morning when I first wake up, and at 5-minute intervals throughout the day when I don't have something else to do. Clearly, if I'm speaking to an audience, I can't be using social media, but the rest of the time, I will be on and off it. And part of the reason for that is that I guess people nowadays have an expectation that they will get immediacy in the response that you give them. In the same way that you send an email to someone and then you sit drumming your fingers on the desk waiting for their response.
Yeah.
With social, it's even more so, I guess.
Yeah. So in terms of platforms and how you use the platforms, have you got a particular routine there or particular favourites? Or
no, I flip back and forth. I tend to use, for the most part, LinkedIn and Twitter and Facebook. Don't really have a preference because they do different things and speak to different people in different ways. I use YouTube. I use most of the networks that are big at some point, but generally those three. Generally those three.
And in terms of blogging, do you have a blog?
I do, but I'm here. We are. This is the point when the copless children are going unshod. I don't invest as much time in that as I should.
Right.
Because I guess that. The main point of my interaction with customers is to talk about them, not about me. So it's my belief that people don't want to hear my thoughts about where monitoring is going.
Right.
They want to hear my thoughts on where their monitoring is going. So
right.
I'd much rather use Twitter or Facebook or LinkedIn as a tool to facilitate that one-to-one conversation and then give them something that was really pertinent to them rather than generic.
And in terms of a device strategy, when you wake up in the morning and do your stuff, are you doing it on a laptop? Do you prefer it, or do you have a big screen? I mean, how do you use the technology?
I think that we're enabled to use it wherever we are. So clearly phones are a big thing at the moment. It means that even when we're travelling, we're not out of touch with people. But I would rather be using a bigger screen. It enables you to get more than just that tiny stripe of content from people. When I, perhaps because of the age that I am, find it very easy to miss stuff.
Yeah.
It's a lot easier if you've got a big screen. So I'd rather work on my laptop or even my desktop, given half a chance, rather than a tablet or a phone. But that isn't always possible.
And in terms of, your in terms of tips for people and in terms of your teaching, what sort of tips do you have for people that are sort of starting on this journey, or they're business professionals who are a little bit reluctant? What are the sort of things that you say to people?
To be brave, to talk more rather than less, because the reality is that people are not waiting by their screens for you to make a mistake. In fact, people aren't listening. They've got better things to do with their time. So to begin with, certainly until you've built a name for yourself and you've got some recognition and you've got some visibility, you'll say stuff and no one will hear it.
Yeah.
So you've got this window of opportunity to be a little bit reckless and make a few mistakes, and that's part of the learning process. But the key thing is that nobody ever wants to hear about you. They want to hear about them.
Yeah.
So you have to talk about them. And that is not a move from this is our products and services to this is what our products and services can do for you. It's a conversation around these are the issues that you're likely to be facing and this is how you can put them right. And actually the product that service that you're selling is totally ancillary to that. This is about the client or the prospect or the person that's interested solving their problem. And if you've pointed them in the right direction, even if you don't get a short-term win out of that, you will have got some kudos from it.
Yeah.
And that will come back, and that will be a benefit at some point down the road. Even if it's just them saying to somebody else, yes, you should talk to these guys because they're really good.
Right, so be brave is your top tip.
Absolutely. And you don't want to flood the streams, but you have to be regular. 10 tweets on a Monday and then nothing for 3 weeks is a waste of time.
Yeah.
10 tweets an hour every single hour is a waste of time because people will just deliberately ignore you. So, but regularity and frequency is important. So, you know, 3 or 4 tweets a day. Some of that will be stuff that you've originated, and some of that will be retweets of other people, and some of that will be comment on stuff. But it needs to be regular enough that I don't forget who you are.
Yeah.
Because when you've got a little bit of traction, you need to capitalise on it.
Right. Brilliant. Great advice. Adam, thank you very much.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.